Guys, welcome back. It is Racer X, and guess what? I've got a pretty cool little video set up for you today. My buddies over at Z Automotive have actually sent me a very cool product that I can't wait to show you. So if you own a six-cylinder, an SXT, a GT, if you own an RT, if you own a Scat Pack, this product right here is something that you need to know about. It does a lot of really cool stuff, and I'm excited to show it to you. I'm going to show you the install, and I will show you everything that this product will do. So I'm actually really looking forward to bringing it to you. Also, guys, if you are new to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Also, hit the notification bell for more great content. And follow me on Instagram. And we are off.
We got the 1,000 horsepower helmet.
God. The guys over at Z Automotive actually sent me a couple of different items. Obviously, right here, this is their taser. I've actually been pretty excited to show this to you and all of the different things that it does. Now, right here, this is their double bypass. So I actually have to install this so that actually we can mount this thing in the trunk instead of the OBD2 port in the front of the car. So I'm going to show you how to install this. Obviously, anything 18 or newer, you're going to need to get this product as well. And then right here, you've got the buttons that actually go on the steering wheel. Mrs. X actually already has buttons in that in the place where these go. But if you don't, then you can use these as well. So I thought I would show you those. So let's see how this bypass actually installs, and then we'll show you kind of everything the taser will do. So in order to install the double bypass on Mrs. X's vehicle, of course it is a 2019, we have to access the trunk. So we actually have to pull up the liner in here and access a couple of things. I'm going to show you how to do it. As I mentioned before, if you've got a 17 or older, you don't necessarily have to do this step, but the nice part about it is once you have the double bypass installed, you can keep your ODB port actually open. So if you want to do any data logging or anything like that, it's still there and good to go. So there are some advantages to doing it this way as well. With the seats actually folded down, this piece right here should just easily kind of lift out, and we'll be able to access exactly what we need right here. So we'll go ahead and do that. All right, now with that out of the way, you can see you've got the battery area here, and of course, you've got your air compressor. Now, the thing we need to access is right here. So we'll go ahead and get into there, and I just need to pull those two tabs back that are right there with this here flathead screwdriver, and we'll have access to what we need. Okay, so this next part is actually quite simple, and it's all you do is take these two wires that come on your bypass harness here, and the part with the blue wire and the white wire goes on the part on the white side there, as you can see. So you just plug it in, and then the part with the yellow and green wire goes on the side with the green plug. So we're literally just plug those two things in, and we'll snap the cover back on. This should be quite easy. All right, now that that is installed, I went ahead and put the lid back on. Everything is back to normal. As you can see, the bypass is coming out here and goes right there. So the next thing that I need to do is actually go back here to the fuse box. I've already popped the lid off, and I've got to go to fuse number 37. So that is actually this yellow guy right there, that one. Boom, I got my finger on it. So that is the one that's got to come out. I've got a little tool right here, whoops, on the inside of the fuse box lid here. So we're going to take that fuse out with this, and we're going to install this guy right here. This comes with the bypass, and we're just going to literally push that in, and this thing should be just about ready to go. So now, with that installed in the slot for fuse 37, all I got to do is plug this in. Obviously, this comes directly off of the bypass. There it is. So I'm just going to plug that guy into what I've installed there on fuse 37. We'll connect it up, and then all we got to do is hit the put the ground in. Pretty easy. As you can see, I went ahead and routed that wire right out down through here, which seems like the natural thing to do, and it's all connected up. Last thing to connect is this little guy right here, and this is the ground wire. All I have to do is go over here to right here. This is a 10 millimeter. All I have to do is loosen that up and just kind of push it in there and tighten it back up, and then this thing is installed. I now have my ground wire attached right here. You've got that other wire coming out right here. Of course, now here we've got the bypass. Actually, I just stuck this underneath the strap for the battery. It seems like a pretty good spot to put it. Now all I've got to do is stick my taser, plug it into that bad boy, and we are ready to rock and roll. So I'll go ahead and put the cover back on this thing. Now, when I'm ready to access the taser, it's just a simple matter of getting in the trunk here, pulling up, and boom, there it is. Already ready installed behind the battery strap. Nice and easy. So now that the taser is actually installed in the trunk of the vehicle, I do want to show you some of the cool stuff that this thing will do. Now, I can't show you all of the features that this thing does because a lot of times it depends on really what vehicle you have and what year your vehicle is. So you kind of have to check Z Automotive's website, take a look at the different options you have there. Also, take a look at their instructions because depending upon what year it is, the functionality of this thing is different. But it does a lot. It does a lot of really, really neat stuff. So if you have a Chrysler 300, you can use this product. Jeeps and Durangos, you can use it. But definitely check on their website before ordering the product so that you know not only what vehicles it's compatible with, but what features you get with the taser. Because like I said, it is a little bit different depending upon what vehicle you actually have. So now that the taser is installed on Mrs. X's car, I have to admit that there are a couple of very specific reasons that I wanted the taser for her vehicle. And being a drag racer, I feel like it's important I at least let you know what those things are. So certainly the fact that this vehicle can now run its fans without the engine being on, that's a huge thing, obviously, to somebody that's a drag racer. It will allow your car to cool down more efficiently in the staging lanes or even out of the staging lanes without having the car running and building heat. So that's actually kind of a cool thing. It's almost like sort of like a chiller would be for my car, except it's for a naturally aspirated version. So if you are a drag racer, you might really, really appreciate that. And also the fact that she runs a drag pack, the fact that you can turn your TPMS sensors off. It's a little bit of a bother that your TPMS sensors, boom, come up in yellow on the dash until your tire pressure is low when you know your tire pressures are good, but that's just those sensors doing what they do. But you can turn those sensors completely off, which is pretty darn cool. One other feature of this product that I think is also pretty cool is if you have your vehicle tuned, we all know sometimes the thing will just pop up with codes randomly. It happens. And sometimes you'll have to go in with your computer and kind of clear the codes out or whatever. I have to do that on my Hellcat sometimes. Doesn't mean there's anything wrong with the car. That just means sometimes there are little gremlins or whatever pop up, codes need to be cleared or whatever. But now I can actually go and clear these codes out directly on the dash, which I think is kind of nice. So once we get her cartooned, I will have that option. So last night I was actually playing around with this thing a little bit, and man, it is pretty darn cool. As a matter of fact, I went through and I actually changed her fonts and stuff to look like the fonts in my Hellcat, or what they would look like in an SRT. But essentially what you've got to do now, once you get in the vehicle, you've got to go ahead and select run. So go ahead and push that thing twice. As you can see, then of course the car will come on. It's kind of neat because it does say SRT across here when the car first fires up, which is obviously different than it used to be. But now what I've got to do is I've got to seek out the audio screen. That's where we need to go from here. And on Mrs. X's car, it is actually on page 7, I believe. There we go. So there's page 7. And now once we're on this this audio screen here, this will now allow us to access the features of the taser. And there are a few buttons that we have to know about. So certainly this one right here. And then there are a couple of buttons right here and here. This is kind of the okay. And this is kind of just keep cruising along inside the menu. And so let's look at that. Another quick thing is you can see I'm actually in the menu for the taser. If I don't keep this back button pushed down, I cannot use this button to navigate through the menu. You can see I'm actually pushing it and it's not doing anything. So you have to keep this back button pressed in, and then you can actually start pushing on this one to navigate through. Now, of course, I don't have three hands, so I got to hold the camera as well. So a little tricky, but I want to show you how to kind of navigate this. So now I'm actually in the taser menu. I've got the left or the back button pushed down with my left hand, and I'm also attempting to kind of hold the camera with my right hand and navigate. I'm hitting the cancel button so that I can show you guys. But you can see the version that's currently in the device. And then as I move along, here we go. So it's telling me what the serial number is on this thing. Now, the very first thing you'll want to do is hit yes on this, where it says to marry the device to the vehicle. Very important step in this whole thing. You won't really be able to do much without marrying the device to the vehicle. So do that. It only takes about 15 seconds. And then you can start navigating through. Do you want to do a full reboot? There's a lot of different options here. First thing I want to show you. Now, there are three different options on the light show, which I can show you here in a minute. If you are somebody anybody that wants to have, you know, flashy lights and all that kind of stuff, I mean, this thing, it will most certainly do that. And there are a few different options there. But as I also click through, there you go. You can read your codes right there. Lots of different options. I'm going to go ahead and skip through. Do you want to unmarry it? No, I do not at this point. You've got performance pages if you want to bring those up. Now, here's the tire setting. As I mentioned to you before, you can actually turn your TPMS sensors off. So now I'm going to actually hit the OK button, which is in the middle, and it will now start letting me know. So now I can either do the base setting on the TPMS sensors. I can go ahead and do the premium setting, and there are just different options. You can read the manual on all the different ways to set this thing up. But if I'm at the track, all I got to do now is just hit none, and now it's completely disabled the TPMS sensors, and now I won't get that annoying thing on the dash that says my tire pressure is low. Something very cool. So in order to use the cooldown feature of the Taser, it's actually quite simple. All I have to do is use this button right here, the right button, which I'll hold down, and then I'll hit the cancel button right here, and it will turn the fans on. There you go. Engine fan is on, it's cooling the car, the engine is not running. So this is a really neat feature. You can use it whenever, and to turn it off, it's the exact same set of buttons, simply the right button here, hit this cancel button, and like so. There you can see the cooldown feature has now been disabled or turned off. I absolutely love that. I think that will come in very handy at the track. Well, just for the heck of it, let's take a look at one of these light shows. Why not, right? I mean, the device does it, so I don't know what it looks like outside. I haven't even played with this, but all I got to do is, you can see it's light show there. I'll hit this this button here, and then I'll hit the center button here, and we'll select one of these light shows, and we'll go outside and see what it looks like. Let's try light show number 2. So that's going off. Let's go take a look at that. Yep, it's definitely doing its thing for parking lot use only, but car, I think I should have Jingle Bell music playing in the background or something. One other quick item of note that's actually cool, I can actually do the light show for my key fob if I just do 1, 2, 3, 4. There it goes. And that enables the light show directly from the key fob, and I can actually advance to the next program show by simply putting the pushing this unlock button again. Now I went to the next available light show, and I can keep cycling by just hitting that button. And then if I want to turn it off, I just hit lock, and there you go. So another neat feature. So the truth is the guys at Z Automotive, they spent a lot of time kind of doing all their R&D and making this Taser do a lot of really neat stuff. And even though it does a lot of cool stuff on Mrs. X's car and the stuff that I would really want it to do, has those track features on there like I showed you, if you have, say, like a 15 to 18 Scat Pack, it will do even more for you because, you know, her car comes really well loaded with a lot of the stuff that the Taser will do for you if you don't have those things already on your car or enabled. And if you have like a 14 or even older in some instances, the Taser will do even more for you because, like I said, it does a lot of the stuff that sometimes you would get from the factory in some of the brand new cars, but it does a lot really for everybody. As a matter of fact, I'll go ahead and run through just a really quick list of some of the other stuff that the Taser will do. And like I said, it really depends on the make and model. So check Z Automotive's website, but some of the other stuff, one, enable the paddle shifters. If you like install the paddle shifters later or whatever, you get that. Also, if you want to install a camera later in the front, you can enable that through the Taser as well, which is pretty cool. You can turn off the seatbelt dinging if your car in your car if you want to do that. Something to think about, I suppose. Certainly the performance and SRT pages, that is a huge one. Now, Mrs. X's car already has all that, but if you don't have that, that is a great feature that the Taser will offer you. In addition to that, you can keep your fog lights running if you have your high beams on. It's just all these little bitty things add up to big things. So there's a lot of configuration settings with the Taser. Certainly you can set your tire sizes and your pressure warnings in your tires. So that's another neat feature. For the Scat Packs, you can enable nearly all the SRT features, including like the steering, and this thing does a lot of stuff. Certainly if you are a track person and you'd like to do burnouts, enabling line lock, Mrs. X's car already has that, but if you don't have line lock, that is another great feature of the Taser. And I can go on and on. I can make an hour-long video about all the different things that the Taser does. I'm not going to do that. I just wanted to show you some of the features that I like and talk about some of the features that I like. Check Z Automotive's website for everything that this thing will do. And that is about it. I want to take a quick second and thank my buddies over at Z Automotive for sending me the Taser, allowing me to show you at least some of the functionality that this thing has. Honestly, I'm still kind of playing with it to find out what all it will do, because I know I haven't figured everything out that this thing will do. It does a lot. So anyway, I'm pretty stoked about it. I know it's going to be great for us at the track, and it has a lot of other pretty neat features as well. You can check out Z Automotive's website. You can order it directly from their website. It makes a great gift. Obviously, we've got Christmas coming up, so something to think about there. And hopefully you guys agree that it's a pretty cool product. Anyway, guys, that is it for this one. I will catch you on the next one. So until then, Racer X.